Right, continuing with two class size versions of something similar to melons but eggs. Two eggs, same size, more or less, same mass. They're going to be dropped from the same height, should have the same velocity. So they should, when they actually land, have the same momentum. So they're going to have the same momentum, mass times velocity, when they hit a surface. They will come to a stop. They both come to zero velocity, so their change in momentum should be exactly the same for each one. They'll have the same start momentum, the same zero finish momentum, they'll have the same change in momentum. We're going to have a look at what happens to the force when we change the time it takes to stop. That's the key bit for this experiment. 3, 2, 1. Oops. Through the same distance, but is it going to fall on the same type of surface? I don't think so. See what happens. Okay. So why was that? Same size egg, same change in velocity, so the momentum when it actually hit the hand was the same, but it took longer to actually come to a halt. So you end up with the change in momentum being the same, but the time being longer, so the force is much smaller, and that's the key to it, that the time is longer, so the force is shorter. Well, if we relate this to a class experiment now, what we can do is create an airbag out of two sheets of newspaper, sellotaped around the edges, straw to blow this up so we've actually got an airbag. It's going to simulate the hand actually moving away, which is going to take more time for the egg to stop. And if we drop the egg from about the same height as before,